Hello, and this is Eric of NotBIOS. Welcome to the History of AMD, Advanced Micro Devices. This is part one of a four-part series where you'll learn where they started and to where they are right now in 2019. Now let's get started. May 1st, 1969, in Sunnyvale, California, United States, AMD, the semiconductor company that makes computer processors, was founded in 1969 by Jerry Saunders and seven former Fairchild Semiconductor employees. Saunders was an electrical engineer. Before starting at AMD, he was the director of marketing at Fairchild. He was known for being one of the best salespeople in the semiconductor industry. Saunders left, like many other Fairchild executives, due to the consistently increasing lack of support, the lack of opportunity, and flexibility within the company. In September 1969, AMD initially became a second source supplier of microchips designed by Fairchild and National Semiconductor. National Semiconductors would later in time face many years of struggles. In 1997, NatSemi merged with Cyrix in a deal worth $550 million. In the end, this only delayed the fate of the already struggling companies. National Semiconductor would later be acquired on April 4th, 2011 by Texas Instruments. Other notables that left Fairchild are Robert Noyce, who had developed the first silicon integrated circuit in 1959 at Fairchild. Robert, together with Gordon Moore, left Fairchild and founded the semiconductor company Intel in July 1968. Under Gordon Moore's leadership, Intel introduced the world's first single chip microprocessor known as the Intel 4004. Many in the tech world know Gordon for the term Moore's Law, stating his observation that the number of transistors per square inch on an integrated circuit had doubled every year since the integrated circuit was invented, being later revised to every year and a half by his colleagues, known as 18 months, which became the de facto standard. But Gordon himself revised this to every 2 years. Back to AMD. Saunders felt he could do more, be something bigger. Indeed, his feelings were correct. As it stands today, from the ground he laid, AMD is now stronger than ever, but faced many struggles that nearly ended them. But where did this company all start? The company started their focus on producing logic chips. AMD saw the lack of quality control as a sore point in the current market and struck swiftly. They guaranteed quality control, stating it met the United States military standard. By November 1969, the company manufactured its first product, the AM9300, which began selling in 1970. That same year, AMD produced its first proprietary product, the AM2501 logic counter, which was highly successful. In 1971, the AM2505, which was its best-selling product, it had the fastest multiplier available. Such progress in such a small little company was shocking, almost coming out of nowhere they climbed quickly. We all have to wonder how hard they worked and what sheer belief they had that kept them going. From almost nobody to someone within a very short period of time of only 1 year. In 1971, AMD entered the RAM chip market. Their first module was the AM3101, which was a 64-bit bipolar RAM. AMD's total sales for that year reached $4.6 million. When considering inflation, that is over $29 million. In 1972, the company finally went public. selling IPOs in the hopes to gather more funding for expansion. In 1973, AMD became the second source for Intel's MOS LSI circuit, MOS meaning metal oxide silicon transistor, aka a MOS transistor, and LSI meaning large-scale integration. Only 2 years later, in 1975, AMD was producing 212 products, of which 49 were proprietary. That same year, AMD reverse engineered a clone of Intel's 8080A CPU and entered the market with the AM9080. These processors received part number 9080A and had enhanced electrical characteristics and lower power dissipation than the original Intel parts. In 1976, Intel entered into a cross-licensing agreement with AMD. This allowed AMD a copper race license to the microcode in Intel's microprocessors and peripherals. This agreement allowed AMD the status of being an authorized second source company. AMD manufactured the 8080 microprocessors in plastic and ceramic packages from 2 to 4 MHz. The specs of these were 8-bit microprocessors up to 4 MHz, 64 kilobytes of RAM, 256 I/O ports, and there were 40-pin DIP. In 1977, AMD entered a joint venture with Siemens. Siemens purchased 20% of AMD's stock. The two companies established Advanced Micro Computers, respectively, in Silicon Valley and in Germany. This agreement allowed AMD the opportunity to enter the microcomputer development and manufacturing field. Eventually, the vision for advanced microcomputers diverged, and AMD bought Siemens' share in the US division of the company in 1979. That same year, AMD also began production of a new semiconductor fab in Austin, Texas, and debuted on the New York Stock Exchange. Things were looking bright for AMD. They seemed unstoppable. In 1980, they expanded even into the telecommunications industry, rapidly growing and innovating. It was in 1981, only 2 years after the acquisition, that they closed the subsidiary company, Advanced Micro Computers. AMD went back to focus on manufacturing second source Intel 86 microprocessors, entering into a 10-year x86 license agreement with Intel October of that year. This allowed either company to be a second source manufacturer of semiconductors made by either company. 1 year later, the agreement also extended to the original 1976 AMD Intel cross licensing deal. The result of the agreement was that AMD became a second source manufacturer of Intel x86 microprocessors and related chips, and Intel provided AMD with database tapes for its 8086, 8186, and 8286 chips. Luckily, not all was lost for AMD. It continued to a successful concentration on proprietary bipolar chips. In 1983, it introduced the INT Standard 1000. This was the highest manufacturing quality standard in the entire industry. In 1984, AMD again made a clone CPU from Intel Designs, the AM286. This CPU was identical to the chip from Intel. However, it had a higher clock speed of 20 MHz versus Intel's 12.5 MHz. The company was spending a massive amount on research and development, focusing on moving forward like it's nobody's business. That same year, they created the world's first 512K EEPROM. If this wasn't enough, they also made the Fortune 500 based on its 1984 income for its first time. This is part 1, the rise of AMD. In the next video, we find AMD holding strong while the others in the tech industry began to suffer. Their research paid off, but in the coming years, they'd soon come to bite off more than they could chew. Missteps, delays, and a huge purchase resulting in massive losses. People feared this was the beginning of the end for AMD.
Thank you for watching, and have yourselves a wonderful day.